What's up, YouTube? It's Tightline Lunkers. We are back at it again with another video, and this will be episode 2 of Tackle Box Review. And today, we're going to be reviewing my topwaters. Let's get them sorted out right about... Okay, guys. So, let's start off with my poppers. So, these poppers, they're pretty small. They've got a rattle, and they've got a U in the front, because when you pull it, along or jerk it, it pushes water forward and it splashes or it pops. That's why they call these poppers. And these is meant for open water because, you know, they've got no cover or weed guards, so you can't pull them along with lily pads. And so these I'd prefer like any walking baits because I don't like how much it disturbs the water. But, you know, sometimes if you just pull it a little bit and it gets a little pop, that sometimes in the morning really gets them going. I put these beside them because these are a little different. Now, I got these out of a mystery tackle box. I can't remember what it's called, but it's got this on the end. And this, it's actually got a lip on here. And this is because it's actually a crankbait as well, so you can pop it. And then when you just constant reel it, it goes under the water like a little lipped crankbait. So these are pretty cool. I've had a lot of luck with these. I've caught in some nice 3-pounders, 3.5s on this. I'd recommend this. And then these. So these are like my bladed topwater. This I also got out of a mystery tackle box. This I'd probably use... not around here, maybe in a big lake, because these, they don't splash, but they do make a lot of chop in the water. I like the action, just, I don't, no fish around here will bite on it. Same with this, the feet, this is my duck lure, the feet paddle, and the hooks kind of buried behind this fur, but nothing around here, or maybe some pike or big pickerel would eat this, but... probably is a very low chance of me eating this. This bait. So this, you know, I cannot remember the name of this bait. It's basically a spinner bait. Instead of just a little like spoon flap on top, it's got like curved blades. So when you rip it on top, this spins and makes a lot of chop in the water. I actually used one of these down by the river. I got crushed by some big smallmouth. Probably the river is the only spot I'd use these 3 lures. But, got a few more of these. I don't know where they are, but, yeah, I don't know. I don't use them that much. So, I did find my other bait. This one's a lot bigger, and I got this out of a mystery tackle box. And it did come with trailers, but I don't know. I don't use this one a lot just because of how big it is, and you gotta crank it super fast. But, I just wanted to show you guys that other one. But, now, let's go to the next bait, which is the frogs. These, you want to use around cover, because they've got the hook kind of, this one's a better example, just up and parallel to the, plastic. And this is because when it's supposed to be on...